इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ओरिजिंस एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ऑपरेशन रिसर्च एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट योर फर्स्ट यूनिट कम्प्लीटली हैज थ्योरेटिकल पार्ट इन विच वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड वन टॉपिक दैट वॉज ओरिजिन एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ऑपरेशन रिसर्च. नाउ In the today's lecture, we will go through the meaning and nature of operational research. So, in the today's lecture, we will try to cover definitions, nature, and if it would be possible, then we will also see the features and characteristics of operational research. Okay. So, actually, operations research has been defined so far in various ways. And it is perhaps still too young to be defined in some authoritative way. So it is important and interesting to give below, to give some definitions of the operations research. Actually, definitions of operations research have been changed according to the development of the subject. So, I'm showing you the nature of operations research. After that, I will tell you the definitions. Okay. The term operations research refers to the application of scientific methodology of several different disciplines. Okay. To problems related to the functioning or operating of some unit, business, government, or institutional management. Ask operations research experts to provide quantitative basis for such decisions, which will permit management to make the best operating decisions. Okay. I will also explain it in another way. Again. So, the operations research are expected by managers to analyze the managerial problem, which involves the operation of systems to gather essential data. Essential data of the system. Okay. Essential data to interpret those data to build one or more models. To manipulate and experiment with those models, and finally to predict and make recommendation about future operations. So since most of the definitions of operations research have been offered at different time of development of operations research, and hence are bound to emphasize its only one or the other aspects. Okay, since here given that the problem is related to multidisciplinary approach. Okay. So since operations research have also a characteristic of interdisciplinary approach, so the nature is with application not only in military science or military, as I told you in the previous lecture when I was telling about the history of operations research. Okay. So operations research is inherently interdisciplinary in nature, with application not only in army and business, but also is medicine, engineering, physics, and so on. Operations research makes use of experience and expertise of people from different disciplines for developing new methods and procedures. Okay. Thus, interdisciplinary approach is an important characteristic of operations research, which is not included in most of its definitions. This is the also nature of operations research. Since we will see that the operations research has interdisciplinary approach, but in the most of definitions, it not included that it is a interdisciplinary approach. Okay. Now, hence, most of the definitions are not satisfactory. That's why we cannot say that all the definitions given by different authors is complete describe the operations research. Again, the growth of operations research activities in organization has been rapid. Means the growth of operation is very rapid, very fast. So the operation research specialists have not replaced manager, nor have they taken over the decision making responsibility. Okay, the correct role of operation research specialist is to help the manager make better decision. First of all, from reaching an inclusion operation, okay, and while chemist knows about atoms and molecules and have theories about their interaction, actually if there would be a pure science, that's like as a chemist means chemical scientist or physicist, research scientist of physics, or a biologist, so these are the pure science researchers. Except these, the operation research is not a science like all these sciences, just like physics, biology, and etc. Because the researchers of science knows about the their researches, just like a chemist knows very well about the molecules, atoms, gases, etc. Okay, and for example, a biologist very well know about the organs or medicines or theories related to that. Okay, but in the operation research do not, but the operations research do not claim to operations. Okay, or operations research do not claim to know or have theories about any operations. Operations research do not claim to know or have theories about operations. Since operations research is not a perfect science, operations research is not a scientific research into the control of operations. Okay, again, operations research it is essential a collection of mathematical techniques. Actually, it includes mathematical techniques and mathematical tools, which is conjunction with or which is joined with a system approach, which is joined with a system approach and applied to solve practical decision problems. Means we will use mathematical techniques and tools with system approach to solve the decision problem of the organization. Okay, now thus it is very difficult to define the operations research. Thus it is very difficult to define the operations research. Now again, operations research may provide top level administrators with a quantitative basis for a decision that will increase the effectiveness of such organization in carrying out their basic purpose. The Committee on Operations Research of the National Research Council, USA, business management major activities are planning, control, and organizing all of which entail judgment or has injected quantification and has brought decision making a major step forward. In the previous lecture, I have also told you that the operation research is a decision making tool. The operation research is a decision making tool by which any researcher or manager or its organization make decisions using the tools and techniques of operations research. okay, and they can also control the business activities using these techniques, and they can also monitor and handle all the management activities related to organization by using the techniques of operations research. Okay, now operations level operation research provides scientific rules. Actually, this is not a scientific, pure scientific research. This is a scientific rules of decision making. For example, economic laws may be used instead of such rules of thumb as order 2 month requirement. There, I think if you have studied about the EOQ model, so we can make the decision that how much inventory we have to require, how much inventory we have to require. Okay, so how can we calculate this? By using EOQ model. So this is also related to your operations research technique. EOQ is also technique of operation research by which you can make the decision of how much lots you have to require for require in upcoming months or the process which is going in your organization. Okay, due to these techniques you can save your organization from the risk which can be occurred suddenly. By using these techniques you can reduce your risk and loss which can be sudden occur suddenly in the organization. This not only optimize the total cost but also roots less or leads to program decision making that can be entrusted to relatively junior staff or the computer. Okay, so it means you can also reduce your cost. That I have told you in the previous lecture that the OR was initially developed for the military purpose only, but in later it was also used in all the field of organization, just like economic field, societal field, business field, military field, agriculture, marketing, etc. So thus we can say that all the definitions of operations research have been offered at different times. Okay, so operations research provide insight into problem for decision at higher echelons. For example, marketing simulations attempt to reproduce the behavior of distributor, customers, and or competitors, especially customer simulation seek to describe the formation of attitudes and buying behavior of actual and potential customers. Now, so this is all about nature of operations research, and by this nature of operations research we will try to discover some definitions of operations research according to H.M. Wagner. Operations research is scientific approach to problem solving for executive management. I told you that there is no specific definition of operations research because it has different phases of development. So in the different time, the different authors has given many definitions. So that's why it doesn't have any specific definitions. Now, according to Operations Research Society of America, what it says, operation research is an experimental and applied science devoted to observing, understanding, and predicting the behavior of purposeful man-machine systems, and operations research workers are actively engaged in applying this knowledge to practical problems in business, government, and society. So actually these are quoted definitions. These are the quoted definition given by some specific authors and some societies. So we cannot change or we cannot modify these definitions. That's why I am reading these definition dicto as they are given. Okay. According to E.L. Aronoff and M.J. Netzer, what they say is operation research is the systematic method oriented study of the basic structure, characteristics, function, and relationship of an organization to provide the executive with a sound scientific and quantitative basis for decision making. So these are different definitions. These are given here. So I will share this this notes in the Google Classroom. So you can go through this by this. Okay. So these are the different definitions. So in the conclusion, we can say that there are so many differences. So in the conclusion, we can say that operation research be a scientific methodology applied for making operational decision. It has no concern about the characteristics of different operation decisions and has not described how the scientific methods are applied in complicated situations. Many more definitions have been given by various authors, but most of them fail to consider all the basic characteristics of operational research. However, with further development of OR, perhaps more precise definitions should be forthcoming. It means if you will go through all these definitions, so you will see that there is no such as any definitions which have included all the characteristics of operations research. It could be possible that in the near future, any author can give or any society can provide a specific definition. It could be possible. Then we will see what happened in the future. So these are the some definitions of operations research. I have told you some definitions, but you go through the all definitions by the notes that I will provide you. And one thing more, that in the examination, for the examination purpose, you have to learn minimum 5 definitions of different authors or societies. Okay, you have to learn minimum 5 definitions. Actually, when your question will become, so what type of question will become in the from the theory part, just like this. Suppose that operations research is the art of winning war without actually fighting it. Operations research is the art of winning war without actually fighting it. Now, you have to comment on this statement. In the examination, an statement or any situation will be given just like that. Operation research is the art of winning war without fighting it. Okay, then you have to explain how you can win the war by using operations research techniques. So you have to know about many definitions and his characteristics, that how they can be used. Okay, and for example, another statement, you can say that operations research is the art of finding bad answer where worst exist. Because in the business organization, you have to make better decision, and you have to make decisions to reduce the cost or reduce to risk or reduces to your losses. So you have to make best decision ever. Which type of condition it exists ever? This is the in the worst conditions, you have to make such decisions that can be useful for the organization or any business industry. Okay, so these definitions and characteristics or nature will help to answer this type of questions. Okay, so this is the nature and definitions of operations research. Now let's go through the characteristics of operations research. What are the characteristics of operations research? The first characteristic, yeah, characteristics and features are similar. So you can say that these are characteristics of operations research or features of operations research. Okay, both are the same. So from the different definitions, if you have know about these definitions, so you can write down the features or characteristics from these definitions. Okay, such like from the first definition, OR is a scientific approach. Operations research is scientific approach. Now see on the characteristics. This characteristic six is the specified about the scientific approach of the operations research. Okay, now similarly in the next question, let us see interdisciplinary term approach. Let us see which definitions have interdisciplinary this. These definitions have interdisciplinary approach. Let us see. This is scientific interdisciplinary problem involving. Yes. Yeah. Operations research is an experimental and applied science devoted to observing, understanding, predicting the behavior of purposeful man machine system, and operations and workers are actively engaged in applying this knowledge to practical problem in business, government and society. These are different sectors or different fields. Okay, so these are the different fields which are interconnected with each other. So you can say that also this is a interdisciplinary approach, and interdisciplinary approach also related with your economics, society and engineering. All these things are interrelated by operations research. Okay, so this is an interdisciplinary approach. Now let us see one by one characteristics of operations research. The first one is decision making. Operations research is a decision science which helps management to make better decisions. For example, if you know about the linear programming, so linear programming is very useful for making decisions in different sectors, such like marketing. I am given an example to you. Suppose that you have to manufacture table and chair. You have to manufacture table and chair, and you have decided some price for table and chair. So what was the quantity of table and chair you have to make by which you can maximize your profit? So suppose that let's x1, I'm increasing the size. Yes, x1 is your chair and x2 is your table. Okay, now for manufacturing table and chair you have some conditions. Means the resources that you have. Suppose that you have some workers and few hours. So after making the table and manufacturer table and chair, you have to require maximum 3 hours for chair and 5 hours for table. Okay. So how much table and chair can be used will be manufactured to maximize your profit. And 3 hours for chair and 5 hours table, but you cannot use more than 12 hours. So how will you write? You will write 3x1 plus 5x2, and you cannot use more than 8 hours. Okay, either you can either chair or table, but you have to make what quantity within the 12 hours. So we will make a condition that we have to apply only we have to use only less than 12 hour or less than 12 hours. So this type of equation will be made. So this is a mathematical formula. Okay, so by the operations research, you can make better decision or you can maximize your profit. Similarly, if you are finding the cost, then you can also reduce your cost by these techniques, such as from the transportation techniques, you can reduce your transportation cost. So there are so many techniques by which you can make better decision to help the management, or by making these decisions, you can get the organizational objectives or you can achieve the your targets. Okay, so we can say that the operations research is a decision making tool by which manager or management can take better decisions to achieve the organizational objectives or goals. Okay, now use of information IT, information technology, that is IT. Nowadays it is very important. Nowadays this is very important that the use of operations research is in IT field, and there are so many software to calculate the operations research technique by computer, such as Cplex. Cplex is a software in which you can calculate any you can use any technique of operations research. Okay, so Cplex is a software. Also Lindo, LINDO, this is also a software which is used to calculate the operations research techniques. Okay, and also SPQVS+. This is also a software by which you can calculate the operations research techniques, or you can use the techniques by these softwares in the your or computer system. Okay, so the use of information technology make operations research easier and for better performance. Okay, so because by using the information technology or computer, you can calculate more complicated situation easily. By using computer, you can calculate complex calculation very easy way. Okay, now use of digital computer has become an integral part of the operations research approach to decision making. Previously, before the year 2000, there was only manually calculation was possible in the operation research, but as the use of operations research has increasing, so the techniques has been also developed, and the computers is also involved to use the operation research. Okay, so by using the computers and information technology, we can make better decision, and it is also possible to make complex decision by using the information technology. The next one is quantitative solution. क्वांटिटेटिव सॉल्यूशन. ऑपरेशंस रिसर्च प्रोवाइड्स द मैनेजर विद ए क्वांटिटेटिव बेसिस फॉर डिसीजन मेकिंग एंड ऑपरेशंस रिसर्च अटेम्प्ट टू प्रोवाइड अ सिस्टमैटिक एंड रेशनल अप्रोच फॉर क्वांटिटेटिव सॉल्यूशन टू द वेरियस मैनेजरियल प्रॉब्लम्स. ओके, लेट अस सी सम डेफिनेशंस अबव. लास्ट डेफिनेशन, ऑपरेशन रिसर्च इज द सिस्टमैटिक एप्लीकेशन ऑफ क्वांटिटेटिव मेथड टेक्निक्स एंड टूल्स टू द एनालिसिस ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स इन्वॉल्विंग द ऑपरेशन ऑफ सिस्टम. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू द डैलेनबेक एंड जॉर्ज 1978, दिस डेफिनेशन वॉज गिवन बाई डैलेनबेक एंड जॉर्ज इन 1978, which is also a characteristic of operations research. Quantitative solution. Actually, we use mathematical tools and techniques to make decision. So when we will get the solution, so we will get only a number. And you have to interpret that number according to the your problem. Okay, operations research provides the managers with a quantitative basis for decision making. Operations research techniques will provide you a number, then manager or experts of operations research or specialist will interpret that number how they can use this number. Okay, actually the operations research techniques don't provide a qualitative solution. If you have any problem, then you have to define your problem in numbers or symbols. And you have to formulate the model. Just like I show you previous, that we have made a model to manufacture a table and chair. Similarly, if you have any problem in your organization, then you have to formulate that problem in mathematical form. And after formulating, you will get the solution. In a number form. Okay. And after getting the solution, you have to interpret it. And this is also your decision that how you have to apply. So this is a quantitative solution technique. Okay. Operations research is not useful for qualitative solution. Okay, if you have qualitative data, then operation research cannot calculate this qualitative data. This is only for quantitative data. Now, human factor. In deriving quantitative solution, we do not consider human factor. Which doubtlessly play a great role in the problem. So study of the OR is incomplete without a study of human factors. For example, suppose that we were manufacturing table and chair, and I have given the condition that within the 12 hours, you have to make a number of table or chair. Okay, but we are not considering the capacity of the human. Means the workers who are making the table or chair, we are not considering their capacity, their skills, okay, their stamina. So we are not considering, or we are also not considering the human behavior. If you are saying that they can work 8 hours, so it is not possible they work 8 hours continuously. It is also possible they can rest for some times, or they can go for lunch, they can go for any other activities. So we cannot avoid the human factors. So without human factor, and in the operations research, human factor is not considered. Okay, let us take another example. If we are making any biscuit in the machine. We are making any biscuit in the machine. So we know the capacity of machine, but without human, it cannot be operated. But without human, it cannot be operated. It could be possible that if any worker which is engaged with that machine, so it is also possible that he can go for anywhere for a time in which the machine can be produced either defect product or any other activities could be possible. Due to that, we have not expected such type of activities. Okay, so human study is not considered in the operations research. That's why we have to interpret all the quantitative solution by the, okay, we have to interpret all the quantitative solution. Now, system orientation, it means actually all the departments are interrelated in the organization. In the organization, there are so many departments: marketing department, HR department, financial department, procurement department, R&D department. So there are so many department, or you can say that there are so many divisions. Okay, so if you have a problem in any division, so all the organization is affected by that problem. So operation research studies the situation or problem as a whole. Operation research studies the situation or problem as a whole. If you have a problem in any division of organization, then the operations research will study that situation as a whole system. Okay, he will consider that problem according to complete organization. This means that an activity by any part of an organization has some effect on the activity of every other part. It means if, for example, if a company manufacturing any product and the marketing department is not working properly, if a company manufacturing a product and marketing department is not working properly, so all the departments will be affected by only the problem of marketing department. How? The production will be increase your wastage, because the marketing department is not able to sell all the product, so the inventory will be increased. The inventory will be increased. So to manage this inventory, the inventory cost will be also increased. Inventory cost will be increased. It means the finance department has extra burden. It means the finance department has extra burden. So all the divisions are interrelated. So when we will try to solve the problem of any organization using OR techniques, so we consider the problem as a whole. So we consider the problem as a whole, because the optimum result of one part of a system may not be the optimum for some other part. Suppose that if we have solved the problem of only marketing department, so it is also possible that the another division can also be affected. Okay, so it will arise again any problem in the future. Therefore, to evaluate a decision, one must identify all possible interactions and determine their impact on organization as a whole. So it means if we are calculating or we are analyzing a problem in a division, so we have to also keep in mind that this problem, how can be affected in the other divisions. Okay, after analyzing that, if this problem is also affect another division, so we will study that problem as if all the divisions. Okay, so this is a system orientation. It means if our problem is an operation research problem, consider as a whole organization. Now, scientific approach. Previously in the definitions, we have also studied this is a scientific approach. Let us see the definition. That is this first definition. Operation, this is a scientific approach to problem solving for executive management. Okay. So what this scientific approach says, operation research uses scientific methods to solve the problem. Okay. Most of the scientific studies such as chemistry, physics, biology, etc. can be carried out in the laboratory. Just a few minutes ago, I told you, okay, such as a chemist knows about atoms and molecules and have theories about that, okay, and a biologist know about living organism and have theories about vital processes, okay, and these researches carried out in the laboratories, and these researches also don't have interference from the outside world. If you are researching on any medicine and in your laboratory you are using that medicine on rats, okay, so this research don't have any interference of outside of the world. It means if you are in your laboratory, so you can work without interference. Nobody is here to interfere you. But in the same is not true in the systems under study of atoms. But at the same time, if you are going to study in the operations research in any organization, this is not possible. Okay? How? So, operation research is formalized process of reasoning. Means, after applying the scientific approach, you have to also apply your mind. You have to also apply your own mind to apply the solution that you have find from the OR techniques. Okay. Under operations research, the problem is to be analyzed and defined clearly. Under the operation research, the problem is to be analyzed and defined clearly. Observations are made under different conditions to study the behavior of the system. How it is possible? We will take an example later, okay? On the basis of these observations, a hypothesis describing how the various factors involved are believed to interact and best solution to the problem is formulated. To test the hypothesis, experiment is designed and executed. Observations are made and measurements are recorded. Finally, results of the experiment are studied and hypothesis is accepted or rejected. So, operations research is the use of scientific method to solve the problem under study. Now, let us an example. Okay. Let us see. We take an example from the finance department. If finance, there is a problem that finance department has not finance department has not given optimum fund to the marketing department, that's why the sale has decreased. Sales has decreased. Okay, why? Because finance department has not given funds to the marketing department for the, you can say that for the different activities like that, promotion, advertisement, and etc. So let us consider a hypothesis that the fund is the reason to decreases the particular year of sales. Okay, so this is our hypothesis. Now we will apply the operations research technique to test this hypothesis. To test this hypothesis, वी विल अप्लाई ऑपरेशंस रिसर्च टेक्निक एंड वी विल ऑल्सो कलेक्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन वी विल ऑल्सो कलेक्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड टू दिस प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू दिस प्रॉब्लम वी विल ऑल्सो कलेक्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट सोर्सेज which are directly or indirectly affect the this condition okay so after gathering the information we will apply the test and we will test our hypothesis we will test our hypothesis and we will get the solution we will get the solution that either our hypothesis is accepted or rejected suppose that if the solution provides that The fund was not the problem of decreasing the cell. So our hypothesis will be rejected. But if we found the solution that if the fund is the problem for decreasing the cell, so it means our hypothesis will be accepted. So we can take essential initiative to increase the cell. Okay. And if the hypothesis is rejected, then we can find some another solution or we can go through the another factors which can be affected, which are affecting your situation. Now, so you can say that operations research is not a pure science. It uses scientific methods to solve the problem. It uses only scientific method and the solution found by the operations is a technique interpreted by the persons okay now operations research is a interdisciplinary team approach operations research is a interdisciplinary team approach as in the previous in the last lecture that I told you origins and development of operations research then I told you operations research is not developed by any one scientist or researcher has not discovered the operations research actually the operations research is developed by different scientists and researchers they were also related to engineering discipline economist psychologist physicist mathematician statistician chemist physicist different types of scientists were included for the development and origin of operations research So the field of operations research is very wide means it can be used in economics in physics in mathematicians and in medical science in chemical science in social science anywhere so this is an interdisciplinary course for example if you are using it in organization so any organization have different departments And I told you that characteristic five that this is a system orientation approach. It means it include all the departments. Means it have related to all the divisions. So all the divisions means this there is so many disciplines. Finance is another discipline and marketing is another discipline. HR is in another discipline. Similarly, it has also. Included different disciplines such like economics scientific physicist psychologist so their operational research is interrelated with all of these so we can say that operation research is a interdisciplinary team approach actually operation research is a team approach it is not developed by any single one okay the next one it helps in uncovering new problems Solution of an OR problem may uncover a number of new problems. In order to derive the maximum benefit, each one of them must be solved. Operation research is not effectively used if it is restricted to one sort problems only. In order to derive full benefits, continuity of research must be maintained. In the scientific approach and human factor characteristics, I told you that. If you are taking a hypothesis if your hypothesis is rejected then you have to find the another factor which are affecting your organization means if your hypothesis is rejected, then you have to try to find the that what are the factors which are affecting your objective. So that's why the operation research also helps to finding uncovering new problems. Okay, and this is also helps in your creativity. When you will uncover new problems, so this will also help to increasing your creativity. Okay, so the researcher must be try to continuously involved in the research of operation research. They have to always doing research on this, on the problems, because one problem uncovers another problem. When you will find the solution for that problem, then another new problem will be arises. So the scientist or expert continuously research must be maintained. They have to maintain their research continuously because it uncovers new conditions and also originate new solution and new problem. Is all about the characteristics and feature of the हेलो हाँ मैम आ रहा हूँ बस अभी क्लास ले रहा हूँ क्लास लेके आ रहा हूँ मैं बस ये 5 मिनट में क्लास खत्म हो जाएगी उसके बाद मैं निकलूंगा तो आधा घंटा लगेगा मुझे ओके okay all about this sir so this is enough for today's class and see you tomorrow on next class